Firstly, we can see the area of the individual shapes is the same in both examples. So the yellow triangle, area of 12, the blue triangle, area of 5, the green shape, 8, and the red shape, 7. Therefore, the combined area of all four coloured shapes will always be 32 units squared. However, the area of half the 5x13 rectangle is 32.5 units squared, which is 0.5 larger than our combined shapes. Now, this is because the combined four shapes don't quite make a triangle. And we can see this when I draw a diagonal of our rectangle, like so, and zoom in, and we can see there is a gap. Now, the area of that gap is exactly 0.5 units squared. Now, the second arrangement has the same area of 32 plus the extra square, making 33 units squared. Now, this explains that when I draw another diagonal, like so, and zoom in again, that we actually don't get a gap this time, but we can see that there is additional area beyond half the rectangle, and that additional area is also 0.5 units squared. So, what is happening? Well, the blue triangle has a gradient of 0.4, and the yellow triangle has a gradient of 0.375. Hence, the blue triangle is slightly steeper than the yellow triangle. Now, this can actually be seen if we take the blue triangle and just move it on top of the yellow triangle and zoom in. Now, we can actually see that they don't quite line up together, and the blue triangle is in fact slightly steeper than the yellow triangle. So, this means that when the blue triangle is at the top and the yellow triangle at the bottom, we get a smaller area below the hypotenuse compared to the other way around. Now, since the gradients are so similar, we get the illusion of one straight line. But it's such an intriguing puzzle because we can rearrange the shapes to create an additional square without actually noticing that this area has moved elsewhere.